Glen McCall, you are both smart, strong-willed, well-educated, well-informed, self-cognizant individuals. I expect, and I think I can speak for all your friends and family here, we expect you to take those qualities, meld them together into an unbreachable foundation to strengthen your relationship and build your marriage. Communicate and talk to each other. Circle the wagons when you have to.
All right.
You're good, bud.
And don't get so uppity when you feel the need to call for help. All of your friends and family here will answer that call. McCall and Glen, live long and prosper.
Thank you. Woo!
As someone who has known you longer than most of the people in this room, I can assure you that she absolutely brings out the very best in you. And as long as you guys continue to be the person that the other inspires you to be, you're both going to be a lot better to find. You're going to be phenomenal. We will always be your motley crew, brother, but we're all very happy that you found your Sharon, and I love you.
Well, the minute Glen came in, it was just a good time, and you've already met my brother. Now it's time to put it on paper, make it legal, and I'm really excited to have you.
I am thankful that you have found someone like Glen with the same ambition and kind heart to give a little sunshine back to the life of someone who gives it away every day. Glenny buddy, words cannot describe how excited we are to turn our little fam of five into a fam of six.
Yeah, I started playing this in Afghanistan when we first got there.
Yeah.
you. Let me make sure this is yours.
Okay. There you go. Thanks, sir.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I think you were wearing these ties.
Yes.
Badass.
Oh, wow.
You
are very cool.
Oh,
yeah.
Alan, those are... I saw you shot glasses from Honduras down there.
Yeah.
So you know, better place to get to you than that.
Oh, dude.
So, yeah, you guys got some nice jars in there so you can enjoy those. Yeah.
Absolutely.
I love it.
Yeah. Here you guys. I'm going to go get dressed and I'll be right out.
Glen, our relationship has been anything but convenient. While thinking about our past 3 years, I went back and I counted just how inconvenient it has been. Over the last few years, we've spent more than 100 hours in the car, boarded more than 40 flights, written more than 60 letters, sent more than 15 care packages, and made more than 900 Skype calls across 4 states and 2 countries. I will never forget the day that you sat on my couch after only dating for 6 months, and you asked in your rare, serious voice if I would marry you. I laughed it off, always assuming that you were joking. I finally realized on the 3rd request that it was you who always knew that we would make it to this day. In case I've forgotten to tell you, you were right. You've always kept me going with unwavering strength. I stand here today a stronger person because you chose to love me. I stand here because every mile that we drove, every plane that we boarded, and every letter that we wrote, you made me laugh, you became my best friend, and you showed me what it feels like to want to spend the rest of your life with somebody. I've spent the last 3.5 years admiring your strength, your creativity, and wondering just how I got so lucky to have found you. Today, I vow to you to always be faithful and honest, to be your partner, your teammate, and your ally in conflict, to be your biggest fan and your toughest adversary. I promise to accept you for both your flaws and your strengths, as you have done with me. I vow to together build a life far better than either one of us could have ever imagined on our own, that our children will always know how incredibly special I think their father is, that you will always be reminded that you are the center of my world. I vow to trust and value your opinions and treat you as my best friend and my equal. I vow to always help you get your feet off the ground while keeping you from soaring too close to the sun. I promise to love you with as much adoration as my grandparents shared, as unconditionally as my parents have shown, with the hopes that one day our children will look at us and be thankful for being the beautiful example of a marriage, one that makes the storybooks jealous. Today, I choose you to be my partner, for better and possibly way worse. I vow to stick with you through it, today, tomorrow, and always.
You guys ready?
All right.
We're ready.
To Glen and McCall.
Glen McCall.
Epic selfie time.
All
right. Epic selfie, friends.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Sarah.
Y'all in there? If not, you don't need to be.
Elliot with one T.
Gorgeous.
Grandma's favorite.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Perfect.
That's perfect.
I
My grandmother was putting together a necklace for me to wear on my wedding day, and so my parents made this beautiful bracelet out of the pearls that she was putting together.
Yeah, she had never really quite finished it. She kind of put it off until the day would come. So we didn't have quite enough, but she had given me a pearl necklace one day, and we put the pearls together and made this beautiful bracelet.
It's perfect.
It's perfect.
Oh my gosh, aww.
Good. You guys are fabulous! I love the jacket! I'm going to stay cool. I'm just going to help you. Stop it!
Little group hug. Ready for group hug? We're getting married!
We're getting married! All right, let's get on that bus.
I'm a little excited, and I can't wait to see him clean shaven.
On a scale of here to here, how excited are you?
Not good with emotion, so we'll see how this works. I still remember the first time you turned around and looked at me. I knew immediately there was something spectacular about you. Over the course of our relationship, we've experienced some amazing wins and some crushing losses. For all the good and the bad, there's no other person I choose to have at my side. You are my best friend, my confidant, my playmate, my mentor in humanity, and my inspiration to be a better me. Thank you. McCall, I promise to support you and be the champion of your passions. I promise to take care of you in sickness and in health, or an emergency room at 3 a.m. I will never lie to you about anything, including addresses. I will always be considerate of your needs, and I promise to never let you feel alone. I will always protect you, be true to you,
and each day I will kiss you before I rush off to work. Lastly, I promise to give my life to you, and that every moment will be devoted to improving our relationship. You are my love, my life, and my wife. I love you.
Thanks to McCall's use or overuse of social media, I don't exactly need to search my memory to recall the events of their relationship. I only need my iPad to remember the play-by-play. For example, Glen delivered McCall flowers for their first Valentine's Day together as an official couple in 2012. Way to go, Glen. And on May 17th, McCall realized just what a great guy she had landed when, after running around town trying to find My Two Moms by Zach Walls and paying for an overpriced copy, she went out on the front porch and found a package from Glen with this exact same book. That day she realized she found her perfect match and wrote, "If you ever wondered if there's someone for everyone, there is, he's mine." But my favorite post of all was on June 1st, 2013, when McCall posted, "It's kind of strange how in love with my life I am. A job that I'm excited for every day, a boyfriend after 2 years still makes me laugh until I cry, and friends that are the most loyal, amazing people I know. It sounds so stupid, but I'm crazy happy. Thank you to everyone who makes me thankful each day. McCall and Glen, I hope that after 50 years, Glen still makes you laugh until you cry, and you still feel in love with your life as you did that last June 1st. Hashtag Wedded Bliss, hashtag Maid of Honor Speech, hashtag Cheers."
Thank you all for being here with us tonight to enjoy this wonderful occasion. You've come from an awful long way, and I just want to say how much we appreciate it. From as far away as Jamaica, Texas, Connecticut, and other locations, Michigan, that I may not remember. So we hope you have a great time. Promise me one thing, dance.
Yo! tonight.